What?
Forgot it was foam and not mist.
Oh, 5:45 top up time.
Good morning. It's show day. It's about 7:15. I just shit myself a little bit because I got to the front of the International Centre where I parked yesterday and the gates were shut. But the athletes' entrance for hair and makeup and stuff is gate B. So, gonna get inside and then I might have something to eat. I might not. I'm supposed to have it before 7:30. It's 7:15, so I probably should have that. I might have it while I'm having my hair done. I'm sure that won't be annoying at all. Gonna get in for our first appointment. Bright and early. Just had my hair done. Mandy, you fucking ledge. She's made it look well long. Got a little plait on top. It's massive. We love it. We love it. We look like BTEC Ariana Grande. Gonna go and move my car around the front. Got about half an hour before my makeup. Think I've got an idea of what I'm doing. Lovely. So we've had hair and makeup done. Big high pony. Lots of greens and blues in there. Spoiler alert. But yeah, feeling good. Just chilling and legs up and snacking on rice cakes because it's going to be a late show and I don't want to be over full. So just little and often at the moment, and Coach will be here soon and Jenna can have a good look at us and see what she wants to play. But yeah, so this is the venue. It's absolutely enormous and the stage is mega. It's just mega. But feeling good. It's a no pressure show. It's just to get up there and enjoy what you love doing show. Feels good.
Ladies, quarter turn to your right. A quarter turn facing the rear. A quarter turn to your right. Ladies, please ensure that you are stood on the line, posing to the judges. Thank you. And that your numbers are visible. Competitor 146, 162, please switch. 162, thank you. Competitor 160, 166, please switch positions. And competitor 152, 162, please switch. Ladies posing with your arms overhead, hands open. Any pose from the side. Turning to face the rear, posing with your arms overhead, hands open. Any pose from the side. And an additional shot from the front. And relax arms down, ensuring that you are posing square on to the judges. Thank you. Audience members, a round of applause for your toned figure competitors. Ladies.
Morning. It is Monday the 17th, the day after the British. Oh Oh god, I've wanted one of these for so long. Wow. Yesterday was just incredible. I felt incredible. Best look I've ever brought. Most confident I've ever felt on stage, which is mad because it was the finals. My posing was better. My posing was confident. My feet were planted. I was stable. It was just brilliant. The only thing that I'm a bit gutted about was that I went the wrong way on my routine. But that's me that notices that. Nobody else would have known. And I styled it out and didn't look like I was shitting myself. Had a couple of cookie box and a roast dinner last night, and it was just hitting the spot. All the vegetables that I've been missing out on when your life consists of green beans and broccoli for a little while. It was nice to have a carrot. And today is another kind of you do you day. So I have got chicken and rice with me, which I do intend to eat. I want to have a couple of treats, but I don't want to fuck about. I'm having the coffee. I've got another cookie treat that someone's made me. I've got a bag of mini eggs as well that I've been dying to eat for a while. I think we're going to have burgers for tea, and I've bought myself some sexy rice instead of just plain long grain. And do you know what? I'm all right with that. If I get into the treaty mentality, it's not that I won't be able to stop, but I don't want to do that and then go back to boring stuff or overindulge today and then be starving the rest of the week. God, that's delicious. I'm going to go to work now. On very little sleep. From the meal at about 10:30, I sorted my shit out. I had washed my tan off. And I just couldn't switch off. I was so excited by everything that's happened. Just had such a good day. I was awake at 4. I think it's gonna be one of those. Excited to go and train later. It's not in my plan to train later, but I just miss it. And I've done pumpy sessions for so long. So feeling good. I'm feeling a bit sad this morning when I was just walking around and it was like, I'm not at the gym, it's weird. But obviously that's part of my regular routine and I won't feel like that forever. But yeah, it's a bit overwhelming. I'm gonna go to work now and show them all the live stream actually, because we can do that, and a lot of them were good that they couldn't watch it, so I will be showing them it at work. You girls been Mackies. What did she pick up? Flat white. Free of choice today. Coffees with milk. Missed those. So, full accountability post-show food. Last night I had one cookie from Cookie Box. I shared another chunky hunk on the way home with Andy. Had a roast dinner. Had a banoffee pie. Today I have had a bagel with some Biscoff. Not measured, but not shit either. I think it's probably about 15 grams just from eyeballing. I had my usual 50 grams of oats and 30 grams of whey, but I added a banana and I had a drizzle of peanut butter and a drizzle of cinnamon roll almond butter. Cinnamon roll almond butter, I'm not sure is the one. Almond butter should just be for chicken with no flavourings. See me. What else have I had today? I've had a packet of mini eggs that have been sat waiting for me since April. Enjoyed every little bit of them. I've had a quarter of a cookie pie that my friend Sarah made for me, and I thought I was going to be sick. Honestly, I thought I was going to be sick. And I've had two chicken and rice meals with a bit of broccoli. I didn't weigh out my chicken. It was the chicken that I took to show yesterday, and I wanted to use it up, in all honesty. I don't like wasting food. And all of that chicken, and I shared out a packet of microwave rice between the two. And that's it. And I'm feeling full. I've been for two sizable poos. My digestion is hating on me. So I'm going to go and do this session, and it's not a planned session. Today is a rest day, or it's a not programmed, it's a eat what you want day, but don't be a twat. I don't feel like I've been a massive twat. Been a bit twat. Only a little bit. Only normal post-show twattiness, I would say. Going to just do a session of what I want to do, maybe 5 or 6 exercises I just feel like I want to do, because I've been on rest days and pumpy sessions for ages and I genuinely miss training. So I'm going to go and do that. I've been picking my nail varnish off today like a scruff. Ugh. I'm going to walk for about 20 minutes or get whatever steps it. I want to do 10k steps today. I haven't got a step count right now, but I just want to keep some of that digestion flowing, and I'm probably going to do a bit of 20 minutes on the stairs. Just keeping things ticking over. And then my reverse starts tomorrow. How am I feeling post-show? Very proud of myself. Very proud of myself. Looking back at some videos and stuff that I've been sent today and looking back on the live stream, which I've inserted, I've never brought more stage sass and confidence. That is such a win for me. No shaky legs. Just genuine, genuine joy being up there. It makes me so happy. And I talked about this in my last vlog. I'm very, very sad to see this stage of my life go now. I will compete again, but not for another couple of years. I've got a lot of growing to do. Glutes, hams and abs, definitely. I just want to be bigger. Everywhere, but paying particular attention to those areas. I still haven't got any feedback yet. I'm sure that will come today or tomorrow. And when I get it, I'll be straight on here. But feeling a bit of post-show blues already, I'm not gonna lie. And just kind of, yeah, it just feels very, very strange. I'm a little bit nervous about the reverse. Wanna keep body recomp in a good place and give ourselves the best chance at a really good growth space. So the goal is still the same, the timeline's just changed. Hopefully just being able to talk about those things and us all being in the same boat, we can all support each other through that, because the reverse is, it's going to be an experience. And I'm going to be very, very honest on here and share it all, how I'm feeling, how I'm looking. All of it. I've got some social things coming up that I'm looking forward to, but also a little bit nervous about, just because. This is such a treat. I said to Andy what I was going to do today, and he was like, "What? Why don't you just get like a takeaway or something on your lunch that you want?" And I genuinely really enjoy my plan. There wasn't anything that I was really, really missing to the point where I wanted to have it today. And I keep trying to tell myself that the food's not going anywhere. I've waited, I think, 42 weeks I've been on prep for, give or take the trip to Mexico and the weeks where we pushed up. It's a long time. I've not been that arsed on things in the last 12 weeks. I kind of had my fill in Mexico of off plan things and stuff that I wanted to eat. The food focus hasn't really been there in this second half of prep for the finals. So I don't feel the need to gorge or have loads of takeouts and stuff. I did really want a gravy dinner and I had it. So yeah, saying that, I'm gonna finish this off. I'm gonna get in there, throw some shit around and get out and go home and wait for my plan to come through from coach, and we'll have a chat about that, eh?
Last of the off plans going in now. Chef Andy on the burgers. By the way, how nice is this cleated wear top? Just saying. Coatscoff. I think they're on buy one, get one free at the moment as well. What's going in the burgers, Andy?
Shameless plug. It's burger night.
But what are we having?
What do you mean?
What are we having on the burgers?
Old school. ketchup, mustard, mayo, gherkins, bit of fresh white onion. Controversial opinion, stop caramelising your onions to put on burgers.
Raw onion, always.
It's not the noughties. It's not as good. Get over it.
And we're going to have one last sweet treat. And we couldn't work out whether to go for from Andy. Excuse me.
I'm sorry.
Bless you. From the America stash, the Nutter Butters, or the Chips Ahoy Red Velvet Cookies.
Your call.
They are cream cheese, the Red Velvets. I feel like which one's going to last more in the tub?
Well, they're in individually wrapped packets.
Are they?
So we're probably better off. You can have one of those and we can still put them away.
Yeah.
Without the rest of the box going spoiling. Soft.
Yeah. Got to be methodical here. Stretch out. Flip reversing. What else we got in here that I've accumulated throughout the year? A chocolate orange from Christmas. Loads of Star Mix. Did you break into those Thornton's Caramel Squares today?
Yeah, I did.
You little bastard.
They were just for you. They came with the Airbnb. They didn't have your name on them.
Oh. Yet to see whether the Easter eggs have made it through the summer. Pray for them. If you've watched this prep series, you'll know that I've bought these, obviously, at Easter. R.I.P. State of that. I bet it's rank. Oh! The devastation. The orange one's just gone in the bin. It's Tuesday, day one of reverse and feeling good, feeling gassy, which is not unusual, let's be honest. I can't remember whether I said this, but my dad post show was like, I hope you're ready for the poo you're gonna have to because of all the different things I was consuming. I hope you're fully prepared for that. And it came today. I'd like to say I was fully prepared, but, you know, feeling all right so far. Not feeling too hungry. It's only day one, so it's going to take about 5 or 6 weeks to fully reverse, I think, and become a bit more stable. But, yeah, everything's good so far. I'm on, how many meals have I had? 3 today out of 6. So, well on our way. And I don't know whether it's just the kind of volume of food that I've consumed over the last couple of days that's keeping me full, but not really that hungry, which is a very nice feeling because I think everybody worries a little bit about the reverse out of a show. So far, so good. So far, so good for the first few hours. An upper session this morning, which felt great. Everything just feels really good. Just feels really good, and I've not lost as much strength going into this show because my calories were still quite high, so I just feel like I'm picking up where I left off, and hopefully as the food increases and my strength increases, they're just going to get better, just better and better. So yeah, looking forward to the week ahead and how this goes. I checked in this morning and I was about 3 kilos up from where I left off last week. I didn't take my scales with me to Telford, so I've actually no idea what my stage weight was. But 3 kilos up, which is fine. That is mostly water. Mostly water, and that'll stabilise throughout the week before we push up again, probably at the weekend. I'm going to check in on Friday because it's my best friend's 30th weekend and we're travelling to Brighton. So I'll get my check-in done on Friday and see where we go from there and how things are going to change into the following week. But coach is happy. I've indulged, I've enjoyed, and now it's back to the graft. Back to the graft. I'm trying to keep my water high. Obviously the food that I've eaten over the last couple of days, I just want to make sure that's digesting well, making sure I'm getting out on a walk. Steps are back at 10k and cardio is back in for half an hour daily. We're back from the gym and I'm swapping today my protein pud for one of the Aldi mousses. Now, I've heard very good things about these. Very excited to try and obviously bring you groundbreaking content and tell you what I think. Oh yeah, that's rich. That's really good. Wow. Okay. The puddings are obviously stodgier. So if you want something that's going to fill you up, go pud. This is elite though. Oh. Oh yeah. I tell you what. I've said it before and I'll say it again. These chocolate, caramel, vanilla puddings that Aldi and Lidl are throwing out, 100% stopped my food focus during the second half of that prep. Not watching food challenges, not constantly thinking about what I'm going to eat post show. Yeah, my calories were a little bit higher, but I just wasn't thinking about it. If you can get a little bit of something like that in your diet, in your prep, your meal plan, I don't need chocolate because I've got one of these every night. That hit it. Still on the 30 grams of oat sludge in the morning and the bagel thin. What more could you want? Living the dream.
It is Wednesday evening. I'm sat outside Aldi, ready to go and get my food shopping done. I've just had a meal. The hunger today has hit me like a sack of shit. A sack of shit. I've just got that meal in to try and subside it. I was starving when I got to the gym, did my cardio. Again, that pushed it a little bit. It is 5:45, so I'll wait a little bit longer when I get in before I have my protein pud. But I might swap that out this week for the egg white pancake just because it sometimes feels a little bit more substantial if I chuck loads of mushrooms in it, because I mean, they're fuck all, aren't they? But what I wanted to come on, my PCA feedback is in. It is so positive. So positive. I'm really, really happy with it. And one thing that I've picked up from it, I mean, physique-wise, it's very much the same as the week before. Obviously, because there's not a lot I can change with my physique in a week. So that's that. What they did say is that my posing had noticeably improved, and it wasn't in my improvements to pose, you know, in a certain way. So, and they said, you know, the posing has improved. Really good job, Hannah. You can see the work that you've put in. And you know what? Isn't that why we all get up on stage anyway? To have our hard work recognised. Isn't it the same? So I just felt like that's a medal to me. Someone's gone, you've worked really fucking hard on that and you've improved it. Great. It just is the same feeling. I'm really, really pleased that my hard work was recognised. I put a shift in. It's not perfect by any means, and it never will be. Posing is something that you can always improve on, but I'm so, so pleased with that. What else came in? A fantastic taper, really well suited to the category. I don't know whether that's figure in general, let's see. They're never going to tell you to push up. I mean, they can tell you to push up into another category, but you would have to be really, really pushing the boundary to be able to do that. But yeah, I'm absolutely made up with it. Said that my lat spread was fantastic. I'll strengths of my quads and my shoulder caps. X frame is good. Like, you couldn't be more pleased with it.
Keep seeing these in Aldi. Oh, Jesus. Nope. This is what we're getting. The content on this channel obviously just keeps on giving. Top up shop, lazy rice, because I don't know what rice I'm being given at the moment, and it is off last week. Obviously, it was peak week, but it is fluctuating, and I know that my calories are going to increase at the weekend. Pumpkin spice bagels, they're not the best, but I feel like I have to make the most of them whilst they're here. They do just taste like the cinnamon and raisin without the raisin, and I am quite fond of the raisin. Topping up on flavours that I haven't got. I've got loads of vanilla ones left for some reason. And because I do quite like them, I don't know why I've left them. Porridge oats, elite chocolate mousse. The only problem with these is that the pot is so tall that you can't stick your finger in all the way to the bottom. And if you're on prep and you're hungry, that is a problem. 10 calorie jellies. I did just say that I am starting to get hungrier already. I'm not going to lean on these as a crutch, but it's good to have them in just in case I want something and it's 10 calories. Mixed veg, standard. And bought Andy a nice little peanut butter Christmas tree because I'm a good person. And that is the excitement for the week. It can only mean one thing. Beeps didn't have cocoa brown in stock. So I used this last night, the Bondi Sands. It's a bit more expensive. I take back everything I said. I take it all back. That stuff's really, really good. And it's taking it off so evenly. I don't know whether you're gonna be able to see. Without any crusty knuckles. Just flashing the engagement ring as well, by the way. Why not? No crusty knuckles. There's no sign of any tiger bread. Not even a tiger roll. Just making sure that I've not got my arse in the mirror. You have to pay extra for that. It's Thursday. Had a very good upper session this morning. Everything is still the same. So I've barely picked the camera up. Because nothing's happening. I feel like my prep face is getting worse though. How is that? I think, like I said, I think my food will go up at the weekend. I am away at the weekend. We're going to go eat. We are at a house party at her house, which is quite relaxed and casual, which means it'll be a lot easier for me to manage what I'm doing. My friends are extremely understanding and know how important this stage is for me. Arguably, is it more important than the prep so that I don't fuck things up for myself for the next God knows how long? Some people would say it is. Big pile of vomit on the floor. Okay. They're very understanding. They get it as much as they're going to get it. And they're being great about it. It's just important that we're having that time together, and that is what we've all come to kind of get. I said get a lot there, but that's what we know is, that's what means the most. So we're all going to be there. I'm not missing anything. I'm not away. I'm not having to do too much cardio. I can manage it in and around the activities that we've got. And I think it'll be fine. It's just going to be a case of what I'm actually packing, which I won't really find out until tomorrow. So that will be the difficult part. But it is what it is. I'm going to get up early, get my training and cardio done, get my steps in, get as much done as I possibly can in the morning so that I can leave work early to go and make some of those amendments to my food before we pack it and go.
And what else will I do tonight? I also need to wash my hair because it's disgusting. I haven't washed it since show. I need to, and there is so much on my scalp, like powder to give it volume and hairspray. It's just absolutely rank. So I need to sort that out. I need to choose what I'm actually packing to wear. None of my clothes fit, so that's actually quite difficult. I need to shave. I want to tan. Seeing my best friends for the first time in a little while. So we're going all out glam. It's her 30th, you can't not. Got a lot to do in a short space of time. That doesn't sound like me, does it? Fucking hell. Yeah, I'll vlog how I get on over the weekend. Reverse wise, everything is going okay. I've not deviated off plan, I don't need to. There are times of the day where I don't struggle with hunger. I'm seeming to be spreading my meals out okay at the moment. I need to go to bed a little bit earlier, because then I'm asleep before I even know I feel like that. And we've been watching some movies and chilling and stuff this week, which has been really nice actually. And I'm using up some of my time off in lieu at work because I'm in that kind of lose it or use it stage before I join another job. I'm just kind of making the most of time at home. I think my body also really craves the rest at the moment. It's my birthday next week, next Sunday. And Andy's like, what do you want to do? I'm like, fucking sit down. I've already kind of given myself the gift that I wanted, which is a week off afterwards in between finishing one job and starting another one. I've got a week off. So that will be great and that'll feel amazing. Really looking forward to Laura's 30th this weekend. Laura came to my show on Sunday. It's such a fucking long way for my friends to actually come to these shows. What they do though is they watch them on the live stream and they support me so much from home, and I just fucking love them. Absolutely adore them. And I've actually had so much support for the finals and for all my shows really, but particularly the finals. My family and friends have been incredible, and had so many nice messages from other people as well that I don't even really know. It's just been mad. And this community that bodybuilding brings is just like no other, I don't think. People supporting people. You don't get any better. Everyone wants to be better as well, and it's just great. I can't hold my camera up anymore. So I'm gonna enjoy the rest of this absolutely fucking disgusting walk. Winter weather is well and truly here. Tell a lie about deviating from my plan. Today, I introduced unsweetened almond milk. I had a coffee with milk in it. Oh, fucking sue me.
Good morning. Friday morning and it's 5:45. Getting up early so that I can go and do my cardio as well as train. Get ready at the gym or at work. Don't know which one yet. Probably at work so I can leave early, because why the hell not? Really? Pro tan ain't just for show day, baby. I've done some for the weekend. I've just done my check-in. I'm coming in at 63.4 kilos, I think, which I believe is less than show day or the last weighing that I did prior to show. I've not put a foot out of place on reverse so far. I think it's been that bit easier because we're very, very gradually increasing the calories. I'm not starving because I never was before, because my calories were that little bit higher. I felt very hungry after my 2 days of eating whatever I wanted. But kind of gradually got used to eating about, I think I'm probably on about 1200. So we've just come back down to baseline. I think she'll bump me up today though. I'll let you know how that goes.
Guess who's back? Back again. Let's squares are back. Let's get fat.
Good morning, it's Saturday morning. We made it to Brighton last night late. Went to see Laura, whose birthday it is today. And we're just getting ready to go ape. I've been and done my rest day cardio, which is half an hour. Did some bonus and glutes whilst Andy was finishing off his session, because why not? And I just wanted to come on because I felt so emotional last night and this morning. Like, I've cried last night? I don't think I cried last night, but I felt really anxious, and I don't often feel like that. And this morning I've got upset over nothing, really. I don't know whether my hormones are just doing a bit of a shit, or whether this is like period related, which again, we don't know when that is, do we, at the moment? I said I would talk about everything, and so I am. And yeah, I don't know whether this is part of the, I mean, I know it is to be expected within the reverse phase, but I didn't think it would hit me in that way so soon. So maybe it's period related, maybe it's just my hormones starting to get themselves back to whatever is normal for me. But so I just wanted to tell it like it is, and that I am struggle city right now about nothing in particular. Overthinking, questioning things. If someone says something to me, I'm like, what was the intention of that? And just over, like, analysing everything. I can be guilty of that normally, but usually it comes with some sort of cycle related thing. So yeah, that's that. Food has slightly changed, and steps have changed. So my cardio is still at half an hour daily. Fine. My steps are at 8K instead of 10K, which I'll be able to do just my walk at work and getting about, round and about. And I'll probably have that done before I even get to the gym, so it's not like there's any extra work to do for steps, which will take, you know, 10 minutes off my activity in a day. And food has slightly changed. I've got more oats in the morning, so that first meal is now 50 grams of oats and whey and a bagel thin with jam pre-workout. On training days, I have a post-workout meal, which is 50 grams of oats and more whey. And now I've got a chicken meal, which is 120 grams chicken, 150 grams rice, and I think 100 grams of mixed veg. And I have that twice. So I have that as meal three, meal four. Meal five is now 120 grams of beef lean mince with 150 grams of sweet potato and 100 grams of mixed veg. So starting to get some carbs trickling in. Again, nothing excessive, pushing me up slowly and gently so that we manage it correctly. Hunger over the last couple of days has not been accurate, really, because like last night I was starving, but I also went to bed at probably past midnight for the first time in a really long time. So I was awake a lot later, and it's not an accurate depiction of how hungry I'm feeling towards the end of the week. I forgot to say, my meal six is still five rice cakes and a protein pud. So not significant amounts of change, still kind of meat, veg, trickling in some higher carb veg, I suppose. Higher calorie, more calorie dense veg. Very, very slowly steady wins the race, I think. I will definitely update as to how hungry I'm feeling and how the emotional side of things are going as well, because I think that's really important. I don't know why I'm really bothering straightening my hair, because the weather's been fucking awful, and as a curly girl, this is probably a large waste of time. All in all, 1 week post show, which it will be tomorrow, feeling okay. Felt a bit bluesy, but then, you know, all the photos start trickling in and you're thinking about it and you're kind of romanticising it and wishing you were back there and very reflective on your achievements. But feeling good that we've kind of set some new goals and I've got new things to work towards. Andy's just come in and looked around. He's like, are you fucking talking to? I'm just vlogging. Oh. Just vlogging some thoughts and feels. Andy, what are your own? Because I was just saying that I've been really weirdly emotional. It's similar to how I get a few days before my cycle, isn't it?
It's almost identical.
Yeah.
I think it's more likely probably a bit of that than anything else.
Do you think, I can't really remember when that is. So it's always been like that. It's always been like that. My periods are very inconsistent. So potentially.
It's almost identical to when you're coming on your period.
Yeah, I said that it feels like that.
Yeah.
Because I can go through phases of how I emotionally come on my period, but I also have a lot of physical attributes to that as well. I mean, yesterday on the way here, I just felt like I needed to poop real bad, but I didn't need one. It's just how my body is. So Andy could very well be right there that's what that is. I think the first week of the reverse is very much like how your peak week was, because your calories are probably still the same. You're going through the motions of it. I think reverse will hit me over the coming weeks, which obviously we will do open and honest vlogging about. We go aping. For fuck's sake, there's always one, isn't there? This big kid. We're actually a little bit further ahead. We've got some more stragglers coming down there. This is so much fun. This is my idea of a good day out. Loving life? Are you smashing it?
Always.
Always. You got this. No! Heels! It is Sunday night. Brighton with friends was amazing. Go Ape was so much fun. Laura's house party was amazing. It was so good to catch up with everybody and we had a great time. Some of us had a lot more fun than others. Andy was very sick, very sick. Look at all my orders that came. I'll show you those in another vlog. I chose not to drink because I've got an off-plan meal, which we're having tonight. We're having a pizza. I've also got a cookie box defrosting. My body's in such a place at the moment that I just want to treat it well. Like, it's taken a battering throughout prep. No matter how good I feel, biologically, it's taken a beating. And I just want to treat it well. And I feel like alcohol is not what it needs right now. And I'd sooner spend my calories on food. So, still got my cardio in while I was there. Ate on plan. The one thing, accountability, that I did have is I had a little square of Laura's birthday cake. And the rest of it was fine. However, yesterday there was a lot more expenditure by doing Go Ape. So she had like a carrot cake blondie. And Aaron made it for her and he cut it into squares like this. So I just had one of those so that I could still join in. And I drank Coke Zero all night. I had a couple of cups of tea, like a little grandma. However, I've discovered this. I don't know what I've been doing, but I'm obsessed with it. And now that I've introduced almond milk in, as like a little, you can have a milky coffee, you can have a tea. I say milky, I have like a drop. But it's just a really nice treat. And I never used to really drink tea, but I'm enjoying that. It's giving me the sweetness that I've obviously got a taste for at the moment. But we just had the most bullshit to drive back. I don't know why it felt like it took so much longer than normal.
But it did, and I got to the gym just before it shut and managed to get my 30 minutes cardio in. And that was about 5 o'clock that I got there. And it's now 5 to 7. I've done my cardio. I've done my steps that obviously I've just been sat in the fucking car all day. Done my steps. And now I'm just preparing my food for tomorrow and we're going to have a pizza together and just chill because Andy is very, very hungover and needs some attention. Bless him. He threw up all down my fucking car. Oh, to be Andy. But I suppose, and you know, we talked about this morning. He was like, I don't know why I got so ill because I only drank as much as I normally would. And he, let's be honest, has been on prep with me and hasn't had a drink for a really long time because he's not been out. So man just had his first post-prep night out and it did him in. So we're going to settle down. Andy's going to feel sorry for himself. I'm going to feel great. I'm probably just going to watch a movie. And that's how we're going to finish our Sunday. But it's been a really good weekend. It's been so nice to just be social. And these are the things that you don't miss out on because if you're smart with it, you can still do it. But, you know, there's no rushing off to the gym to get something done, even though, you know, I try to factor it in. Well, I do factor it in where I can on prep, but the pressure wasn't there. And that was nice. It was like, I'll go and get that done first thing in the morning so that I can enjoy the rest of the day. There was never anything else to do, which was nice. And I enjoyed those two rest days, even though they weren't quite rest days, but I enjoyed them very much. I'm going into my final week at my job, which is crazy. Feeling all right about it, feeling a bit weird, feeling, you know, just everything that I've achieved over the last 3 years there and reflecting on that and everything that I did during COVID, building mortuaries. My specialist area is excess deaths and mass fatalities. So I've had a very strange start to the job in December 2019. I will be sad to leave there. It wasn't something I was looking to do particularly. I'm sad to leave some of the people, but really looking forward to new adventures, which will bring me so much more work-life balance and will allow me to focus on things like my coaching and doing stuff like that. And just building a better life for Andy and I, to be honest. A nice week to look forward to ahead. And then I've got a week off. Don't know what to do with myself. I probably will do fuck all. And it's going to be great. You getting ready to heal your hungover soul?
Yeah, I'm not sure if pizza will do that, but I'll have a go.
It was a bad one, wasn't it?
It was.